Blake X, and this is another Nuclear Reaction. Genuine reviews and breakdowns to metal, rock, and beyond. So I am back with another Patreon request. Another one from Pan Galactic, who asked me to check out The Glass Prison by Dream Theater. Now, I've heard a handful of Dream Theater songs over the years, but I doubt that I've ever heard this one before. So, genuine first-time reaction. Dream Theater is one of those bands that, for whatever reason, I just never sat down and committed myself to really listening to a bunch of their stuff. So basically, I haven't really given them a chance, and now should be the perfect opportunity to do that. I have heard a lot of good things about them, and this song is over 13 minutes long, so that's pretty intriguing. I'm guessing this one is going to take me on a journey. We'll find out. I think someone told me at one point, actually, that Dream Theater has as loyal and as ravenous a fan base as Nightwish does. So that makes things all the more interesting. It's always kind of cool when a band or an artist has that level of a draw, like, just commands that mass respect and appeal within its community of fans. So we'll see if it lives up to its reputation for me personally. Bear in mind that I'm always honest with my reactions, so whether I like it or not, I'll let you know. And just a friendly reminder, it's just an opinion.
That's my opinion!
So, don't take it too seriously. It's not a case of me being a metal elitist or anything like that. I give my opinion and my perspective. That's very much what these reactions are all about. So we'll see whether or not I like it. Okay, so before we jump in, I just want to let you guys know that if you want to get a song reacted to right away, the best option for that is going to patreon.com/nuclearreactions and joining Tier 4. That's the $80 tier. And that's basically how you speed up the process of getting your request looked at. Otherwise, you could leave song requests in the comments. And if I pick yours, it goes on something called the infinite list. If it's on that list, I will get to it eventually. Eventually being the key word, however. So you have two options open to yourself, but if you are interested in the Patreon choice, it will be linked in the description beneath this video. Alright. It's been several reactions since I've reacted to something very long, so the length of this song kind of excites me. I remember the time when I was just completely against the idea of reacting to long songs. Things have definitely changed. Okay, The Glass Prison, very interesting title. And I really don't know what to expect here, so let's jump right in 3, 2, 1, go. Static. Hope I got a good version of the song. One thing I immediately have to point out, one thing I really like, and again, I'm noticing the drumming a lot more in songs I react to, but I really do like the drumming so far. Of course, I'm not a musician, as I always say, I don't play an instrument, but the drumming, to my ears, it just sounds very textured, you know? It just sounds like really good. I mean, there's no other way to put it. I'm really enjoying the drumming so far. I'm also really liking that synthy 80s kind of sound they have going on. Was not expecting that at all, but it's a nice bonus because that kind of surprised me a bit. But yeah, I like it so far. I have not heard the vocals yet, so I can't make any statement about that yet. But so far, so interesting. So let's keep going. I like this guitar.
We'll be right back.
Like, this part sounds really sick. I'm into this a lot. Okay, it's getting better and better. Different musical journey than I was expecting, but a journey nonetheless. Like the build up right here. Okay, the vocals so far sound very thrashy. Maybe that's a bad comparison, but that's what I feel so far, just hearing the initial vocals. It sounds good. I like it. What I really like, though, is the riffage and the drumming. The instrumental work is phenomenal in this song so far. Dream Theater fans are probably rolling their eyes saying, of course it is. But yeah, for me personally, I'm really digging this so far, more and more. So let's get back into it. Okay, so I'm going to say this about the vocals. I don't love the vocals, but I like them quite a bit. But more than that, I think what really makes the song stand out is just the brilliant instrumental work. The vocals are good, though. They are, in my opinion. But they're just not something that's... I'll put it this way. They're not my first choice for vocals in a metal song. So yeah, that's pretty much how I feel about that so far. But yeah, the guitar now is really blowing me away. You know, first it was the drumming. Now I'm really appreciating the guitar work. So let's jump back in. Interesting about the police sirens. I wonder what that represents. I was not expecting turntables either. Thank you. song has really, like, defied my expectations. I don't know what to expect. Now we're getting some gang vocals here. A lot of variation in the song. Versatility. He's taken his voice to a bunch of different places. So this song is, I think this is a song that by necessity requires a lot of multiple listens, because I think it's a grower in the sense of how complicated the music is, and by how varied the sound is. Like, just on an initial first listen, I immediately very much like this song, but I think that in order to fully appreciate it to the fullest extent, I'll probably have to listen to this again like another 3 or 4 times. It's like that kind of a complex, really well done song. So that's my feeling on it so far, but we've still got some time left to go, so let's get back into it. Thank you. Okay, I wasn't sure where to pause it. I didn't want to ruin that solo. But this just, like, goes from one guitar solo to the next. This is really good. I mean, I don't know the right words to express my level of impression by this song, but I'm very impressed. This is, like, I can see now the appeal of Dream Theater. I mean, this is, like, really solid. It's more than solid. It's, like, it's pretty phenomenal. I'll just put it that way. Like, I'm really liking this song. It's a great introduction to this band. So, yeah, let's get back to these solos. Let's finish it up. Then you've got the synth, the bass. Really good. Encourages different styles of editing. That was a really abrupt ending, but hey, it worked, you know? Okay, yeah, so just going to state the obvious that this was a crazy good song. Extremely talented artists, Dream Theater, you know? Much credit, much respect to these guys, because this was brilliantly done. It went, like I said, it went from one solo into the next, which is great all around. Great guitar work, great bass work, great synth work, great drumming. The vocals, I like them. Initially, I didn't love them, but toward the end, I appreciated them even more. And I liked how they used vocals to end the song rather than end it with the guitar solo. I thought that was a nice little twist and nice little change-up. Speaking of change-ups, this is structurally... It feels structurally a little bit different than what you would commonly expect. Like, it defies the norms and the normal framework and template of a metal song, in my opinion. And once again, I'm not a musician. It's possible I don't fully know what I'm talking about. But also, I think these guys are, you know, progressive metal, even though I detected influences from several other genres in here as well. But yeah, if they are progressive, it makes sense. It kind of comes with the territory for prog metal. But yeah, speaking of other influences, there were, like, other bits of genre styles that I picked up on throughout this song. Like, when they brought in the turntables, that part felt very... It felt like, if nothing else, it was paying homage to nu metal, you know? And then there were other parts that felt... a little bit thrashy. Maybe that was owed to how the vocals were used, especially toward the beginning. And there were some other parts that felt maybe even slightly power metal, you know? So you know, and I know it's not strictly any of those genres. I'm just saying I think that those genres left their fingerprints on various sections of the song. And I like that. I think that was very interesting. Once again, the song had a lot of variety, a lot of versatility, a lot of diversity in sound and influence. And I thought it was a very, very well-made song. I really loved this a lot. And I'm going to listen to this again because, as I said before, I do think this takes more than just one listen to fully appreciate and to fully pick up upon the scope of this song. Yeah, I think that's the best way I could put it. Like, this is one that you kind of have to let marinate in order for your appreciation of it to grow even more. And I think that's what's going to be necessary for me as a listener. But as for a first-time listen, this was a great introduction to this band. It was really my first time sitting down and listening to Dream Theater by choice. You know, I've heard it played once or twice. A friend played it once. I've had it played in the background on someone else's computer, things like that. But that was years ago, you know, and I never actually sat down and said, okay, I'm going to listen to Dream Theater. I'm really going to sit and pay attention to the sound, you know, to the lyrics. We'll get to the lyrics in a minute. But yeah, like, I never gave it the time of day. So now, this is an excellent opportunity. And by the way, that's an invitation for you guys to leave comments down below. If you have further requests or suggestions to more Dream Theater songs, let me know. I can put them on the list, or otherwise you have the Patreon option. But yeah, musically, nothing to complain about. I have no criticisms about it at all. I really liked it from beginning to end. So, that being said, let's get now to the lyrics. And let's see what we're talking about. Cunning, baffling, powerful, been beaten to a pulp, vigorous, irresistible, sick and tired and laid low, dominating, invisible, blackout, loss of control. Overwhelming, unquenchable, I'm powerless, have to let go. I can't escape it, it leaves me frail and worn, can no longer take it, senses tattered and torn. Hopeless surrender, obsessions got me beat, losing the will to live, admitting complete defeat. Fatal descent, spinning around, I've gone too far to turn back around. Desperate attempt, stop the progression, at any length, lift this obsession. Crawling to my glass prison, a place where no one knows, my secret lonely world begins. So much safer here, a place where I can go to forget about my daily sins. Interesting. Life here in my glass prison, a place I once called home, fall in nocturnal bliss again, chasing a long-lost friend. I wonder if this is about drug abuse or something, you know? Because when I hear chasing, I think of like things like heroin, things like that, you know? I can no longer control, just waiting for this hopelessness to end. Run fast from the wreckage of the past, a shattered glass prison wall behind me. Fight past, walking through the ashes, a distant oasis before me. That's very well worded. Try desperate crawling on my knees, begging God to please stop the insanity. Help me, I'm trying to believe. Stop wallowing in my own self-pity. We've been waiting for you, my friend. The writing's been on the wall. All it takes is a little faith. You know you're the same as us all. I can't break out this prison all alone. I'm drowning and I'm hopeless on my own. Heal me, I can't restore my sanity alone. Enter the door, desperate, fighting no more. Help me restore to my sanity at this temple of hope. I need to learn. Teach me how sorrow to burn. Help me to return to humanity. I'll be fearless and thorough to enter this temple of hope. Believe, transcend the pain. Living to live? I don't know. Maybe that's a botched lyrical line there. Living the life, maybe. Humility. Open my eyes. This new odyssey of rigorous honesty. That's very well. This is a well-written song. And a very, very long lyrically. Hoping not to bore you guys by reading all this off. But, yeah, serenity I never knew, soundness of mind, helped me to find courage to change. All the things that I can. Courage to change, I probably should say. Whoever supplied these lyrics, I just Googled it. It's just, I feel like they misspelled a lot of shit. But anyway, we'll help you perform this miracle where you must set your past free. You dug the hole, but you can't bury your soul. Open your mind and you will see. Way off in the distance, I saw the door. I tried to open. I tried forcing with all of my will, and still, the door wouldn't open. Unable to trust my faith, I turned and walked away. I looked around, felt a chill in the air, took my will and turned it over. The glass prison which once held me is now gone, a long-lost fortress armed only with liberty and the key of my willingness. Fell down on my knees and prayed, thy will be done. I turned around, saw light shining through. The door was wide open. This is interesting because it's an example of a song that you can look at from multiple angles. And it's possibly saying several things at once. Like, it occurs to me that this is probably a very deep band, in every sense of the word.
Giggity giggity.
Not in every sense of the word. That came out wrong. Disregard that. Anyway, so what they say here is probably intentionally very complex. Maybe even part of a larger story that they're trying to say on this album. But I'll take a crack at it, as always, and give my perspective. I think this is about a person who feels somehow entrapped and who has fallen out of touch with who they really are, and in their worldview, finding faith, or maybe even rediscovering it if they lost it. That's what they see as their way out of the glass prison that they made for themselves. And what I think the glass prison concept is getting at is that this person is overwhelmed by guilt and surrounded by reflections of who they've become and what they've done. So seeing yourself reflected all around with no escape, I think, in the case of this song, I think it's metaphorical for someone who has confronted their actions but can't take the next step to fix themselves. You know, there was this quote that I saw online the other day, and I normally am not someone who likes all these inspirational quotes that people share. Like, I just think 90% of the time they come off as really vapid and massively generalizing whatever they're referencing. But there was one that I thought was good that I saw, and it said, I have traveled through madness to find me. Very interesting. So I think that this is probably a case of that. But for this person, the phrase would be tweaked slightly to say that they are traveling through madness to find their faith. Which, you know, as a non-Christian, I obviously don't believe in blind faith. But I do believe that if something has a substantially positive effect on someone and gets them through whatever their suffering is, then more power to them. That's more or less my philosophy. What works or what doesn't work for me won't be the same as what works or doesn't work for someone else. And that's perfectly understandable. So that's pretty much my, you know, perspective there. But the other thing is this song doesn't go into detail about why this person is in the situation, what caused it. But I suppose that isn't really the point. The song is looking to highlight other things with its message, you know. But I do think that whatever has caused this person's situation and the glass prison has to be something probably self-inflicted, something self-destructive, whether it's self-harm or substance abuse, unwillingness to confront something that they did in the past. I really think it has to be something internal, not external, because this song goes out of its way to revolve the entire process of this person's pain around the person himself. It really doesn't mention other people. The only other people it does mention are his reflections, right? Now, the only point of contention that I have with this, and again, if someone uses faith to successfully get back on their feet and heal, then I support that, you know. But I do think that's still only one small facet of a larger problem, which is the lack of self-empowerment that this person seems to have. And so I think that something has to come from within in terms of strength, because if you put all your eggs in one basket, particularly a basket that hangs on the arm of an invisible being, then, you know, you're not leaving the other doors open for additional recovery for yourself. And I think that whenever a person gets really low in life and they're trying to climb back to the top and heal, I think in that situation, you should really try and establish as many personal safety nets for yourself as you possibly can. And so in my view, immediately looking into something else only in order to get better, just that one thing, and completely ignoring the possibility that you already have the power in yourself, I do think that's a bit myopic, often to the detriment of mental and emotional health. So, yeah, so that's my little disagreement personally with the song's overall message. But I think that the way this is communicated is done very well. I think this is a well-written song, and the band finds a really, really verbose and emotionally sharp way to express what it wants to. So, very well crafted. I gotta commend them for that. They did a good job here. And, you know, I've heard people praise Dream Theater for the music, but really haven't heard anything about their lyrical quality. So, as this is the first song by them, I'm really sitting down and reviewing. You know, it's good to see that they seem just as talented in the writing department as they are musically. Once again, it's that perfect balance that you don't often find in a band, but when you do find it, it's really nice. And I like how this song describes this person's mental struggle or the emotional sort of tug of war he's going through with these really vivid visuals. Like, it's such a long song lyrically, I gotta find the line. Like here it says, way off in the distance I saw the door. I tried to open, tried forcing with all my will, and still the door wouldn't open. That immediately evokes thoughts about someone who can see the solution to their problems, but they can't get from point A to point B, even though they feel like they're putting in the work to get there. It's sort of like, I think the best way I can describe it in my own visual terms is like, imagine you're climbing up a really tall, really steep hill. And no matter how much you climb, when you look up, it's still just as far away. Like the top of the hill is just as far away as it was in the beginning. That's kind of what I think of when I read a line like that. And I can relate to that in a way, because when I'm feeling dejected or in a bad place mentally, one of the things that can pull me out of it is actually doing these reactions. Like, it does a good job of boosting my mood. But there are times when it just feels out of reach. You know, it's like, I just can't grab a hold of it. You know, like, I can see the option there. I know if I just push myself a little bit more and film something, I'll feel better. But there have been days where it very much does feel like a door that won't budge. It won't open. So actually, I didn't even think about it on my first read through of these lyrics, but that verse to me is actually quite relatable. So, and of course, at the end of the song, he feels better, right? The door opens, and the conduit through which that happens for him happens to be faith and spirituality. And it says, armed only with liberty and the key of my willingness. So before, he wasn't willing to do what he knew was necessary to change and break out of the glass prison. But now his willingness is the key that unlocks the door. And again, while I don't ultimately agree with the solution that works for this person, I think once again, the way that these lines are delivered, it's fantastic writing. So this was a really good song. It was excellent musically. It was excellent lyrically. In terms of rating, I am going to give this an 11 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. The reason I'm giving it an 11, I'm giving it a slightly reserved score, is because once again, I do think this song will grow on me more and more with each listen. And so because I've only heard this song from beginning to end once, I don't think it would be fair to just right off the bat give a 12 to this one. So my final score for this is an 11, but it was excellent. I was really impressed by this, and I definitely want to check out more by Dream Theater. So leave your requests, leave your suggestions in the comments below this video. And that's pretty much it, my review, my breakdown. Thank you for subscribing. If you're not subscribed yet, hit that button. Hit that bell if you want notifications. Once again, check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions. And that's all I got for this video. Much more content on the way. Much love and respect to the nuclear family, and I will catch you all on the next one.